Hello and welcome to my channel Living with Disabilities. Today I'm going to talk about CT scan and what is a CT scan. CT scan is a scan that is made to look inside the contents of the human body, inside the brain, inside the skull, inside the stomach, inside everything, and they would get a very good image, compared to an x-ray. So it does show, depending on the type of the CT, it shows different contents or different organs of the human body. So I'm going to talk about the CT scan with the iodine dye, which is the contrast. And the CT scan itself, without contrast, it takes 2 to 5 minutes, no needles included, and it's not painful at all. It's very quick. You will not even need blankets. The machine itself is not noisy. There's just a lot of fans everywhere. I'm not sure if that's part of the machine or the room itself, the imaging room itself, and no IV needed for that test. So that's it. So the CT with contrast, which is a substance that they will be injecting. So a CT scan with contrast is not the same as a CT scan, and I wish I knew what was it like before I did it. That's why I'm making this video. So it looks like you're going to the usual CT machine, okay? But before that, they would have an IV inserted in your arm, and within the test, they either would do like the MRI that I talked about in the previous videos, either they would have a tube that is long enough, and they would be inserting the contrast while you are inside the machine doing the test, or they would come halfway and they would inject with a needle. I'm not sure which way actually they did. I don't remember. However, when they need the IV, and when they injected the IV, the contrast, I think I did it 2 or 3 times. It really burned my veins to the point that I was feeling the track of the contrast like literally climbing up my veins. This is how painful it was. However, I need to point out that I have very, very thin and weak veins, so it's not the same to all people. So I do have difficulties, great difficulties, even with regular IVs, just fluids. They would hurt me so bad. So this might not be the case to everybody. So when they inject this and you're inside the machine, and it's still the same test regarding the noise and the ceiling, it's not closed like an MRI machine and it's not noisy, you will feel this first, the burning, if it might burn for everybody, if it might burn. And then comes the big surprise that I wish somebody told me. The last bit of the test, the last 5 minutes of the test, I felt a flush of heat from literally the chest and the waist all the way down my legs. The heat would be so much and so real to the point that I really felt, and sorry for the expression, this is how it felt like, that I almost peed my pants, and I went running to the toilet to see if I actually have something on my pants. And I was like so exhausted and so tired at that time when I was in the hospital. But that feeling, and it does last for more than a few minutes. It's not like just seconds. It does last.
Oh dear.
So it does last more than a few minutes. And I just needed to run to the toilet and make sure that there's nothing Oh, my cloak was so. They did not inform me. They told me that you will feel some heat, but they did not tell me where and how and exactly how does it feel like, because it felt like there's like something and it's spreading all the way down, like literally somebody is pouring warm water from the waist down your legs, all the way down your legs. But there's nothing. Every time I would do the test, I would run to the toilet again and I would find nothing again. But there's nothing. There's nothing. It's just the test. And you are advised to drink plenty of water to get rid of the contrast. In the MRI, they also told me the same. I'm not sure how healthy or what does it do. It's just like water is good for you. Drink as much as you can. That's it. So that's the video. It's quick and it's something I really wished I knew before I ran to the toilet like a crazy person, maybe bumping into somebody on the way. I don't even remember, but this is how embarrassing and real it is. And you can see that I'm feeling good. Like a quick update, I'm feeling pretty good when it comes to my headaches. And I'm not really having a headache anymore. And I hope that will last. This will last because, like I said in the previous videos, I did have some times of improvement, very short times, and then I would have a decline, very steep decline, and it would last for months. And I've been very sick for months, so I'm just so relieved, and I want this to be full recovery. I've done so far 10 shunt, 10 brain surgeries in my life. I'm sure others would have more, others would have less, but I feel like this is the number, and that's it. I'm done with hospitals, and I quit. However, I'm not quitting YouTube. Hopefully, I will upload some goofy content for you soon. Right? Okay, so I'll see you soon on YouTube. Bye bye.